Hello and welcome back. This is the Clay Golem. This is Foundry VTT version 12. And this is a little tips video about buttons and switches. Now, some of you have watched my videos for a while. You know that I love using Monk's active tile triggers for buttons so that I can do stuff. Well, somebody asked in the comments about how do I get them so that my incursive Strahd, my buttons, when I click them, they go green. How do I do that? So I thought what would be useful is just to retouch about buttons and things and to show you how it works. So on the left here, I've got a black button. When I click it, the light comes on and it turns green to show that it's active. If I click it again, it turns off. Nice and easy. And I can click it as many times as I want. Now, this button doesn't have anything on it, but I could easily take a text box and just write over there and change that to say whatever I wanted, such as button, because that's all that is. Tiny, yeah, that'll do. That's all that is just a text box over the top of that button so you can see that it's doing it. Nice and simple. And here I've got, it's almost exactly the same. It's almost exactly the same setup. But when I do this one, you may well be able to hear that it goes click, as well as seeing that little bit of writing that says click. Obviously, the switch itself moves and the light comes on. Now, I'm using lights, but that could be anything. That could be revealing a tile. That could be porting something in. That could be opening a door. Whatever it is, I'm just using lights for this demo. So how do these work? Well, first of all, I'm going to get rid of that text off of there because that's not part of the button. That's just the label. So if I go to my tile controls, you need Monk's active tile triggers to do this. Okay, so if I look at this, you can see that this is actually just a tile. If I double click it, how do I set up this button? So under the basics, I've not changed anything there. What it is, it's this triggers section. The first thing I want to do is come in to my images, and I've got two images. And again, if you've watched my Cursor Strahd, you've seen me use this. I have a interface folder where I have two pictures. One is black, one is green. And I've added those two images on. So I've got this one happens to be button background, and then I've got one called button active. And it literally is the background is black, the active is green. That's all it is. That's all I've done. Really, really simple. So I've added those two on there. Under the setup, I've just got this so that when you click it, it does the actions. Really simple. What are the actions I've got here? So this is the important bit. This is the bit that's doing the work from that switching the color of the button. I'm literally saying switch the tile image for this tile and just change it to the next one. Remember, the images are these ones. So it's currently showing image one, which is my black one. And then when I click it, it will switch tile image on this tile to the next one, which is the green one. If I click it again, it's going to switch it to the next one, which is, oh, back to the beginning of the list, number one again. That literally is all it's doing. So it is really, really simple to do that. The other action I've got on here is just to toggle the activation of that light. So it literally is just turning that light on and off. Now, it's not saying, oh, if you click it and the button is black, then turn it on. It's just saying toggle it every time I click that button. If it's on, turn it off. If it's off, turn it on. So you get this effect where you get the button color changing as well as the activity turning on or off. Yeah, nice and simple. So what about this one? This one's slightly different, but not much. It really isn't much. So let's have a look at what's going on in here. This image of a lever, by the way, I just Googled lever, found an image. So it's the same. I've got that original image, which was the lever pointing to the left like it is now. And then all I did was copy and paste it and called it right and then flip the image. So I literally have it looking left and then it looking right. Looking left, looking right. So it's exactly the same image. It's just which way it's facing. That's all I did for that. So you can see that that's the same as black or green background. I've just got the picture changing. Setup is exactly the same, as in click it and it does it. And my actions here, again, it's literally that switch the tile image on this tile, change it to the next image. So it's going to flick between those two images. That's it. I also added a play sound, which is why it's got that little click noise. Not sure how well that's coming across on the video. Hopefully your ears are not bleeding, but you could hear it. I'm going to go the other way and make my sounds too quiet now. So that plays that. And again, I just got it to toggle that light on off. That's all it's doing. And then I added scrolling text that says the word click on this tile. Everybody can see it. 2 seconds was pretty much about right speed wise, I felt. And I just anchored it to the bottom with it moving up. And then that's the effect we get. And I think that's really sweet. So you could absolutely put this lever in your game and make it player clickable. And they come along and they go, oh, click, and then something happens. A door opens. You know, people love levers. If you put levers in your dungeon, they click that and a gate opens and stays open that allows out some horrendous monster that's going to attack them. That would be hilarious. And they can't complain because they did it. Which is brilliant. So that's it. Just a little refresher on buttons and what you can do with them using Monk's active tile triggers. That's the only thing I've got installed for this. I don't need to use anything else whatsoever. It literally is just flipping between one image and another. Anyway, hope that was useful. Take care. I'll see you in the next one.